All right, guys, we are at O'Reilly's.
Let me go ahead and show you right there.
We're at O'Reilly's and we're about to go ahead and purchase the cold cannon cold air intake for the 3.5 here. So yeah, we're gonna purchase it. And I think last week I came in and the lady said that they didn't have it in stock, so I had to purchase it, and then they were gonna order it and I was gonna get it the same day. So yeah, I came a little bit earlier so I can get it a little bit, probably around like 3-4 maybe today. So yeah, we're gonna go inside, we're gonna purchase it, and yeah, I'll see you guys when we get it. All right, guys, so we successfully ordered the cold air intake for the 3.5 here. So it's gonna get here at 3 o'clock, so they're gonna call me on the phone and I'm gonna come pick it up. And I think I'm gonna install it with my friend Xavier tomorrow. I don't think I'm gonna be able to do it today because he has work and I'm off today and tomorrow. So yeah, we're gonna do it early, install it, because he installed his on his Evo 10 like I was telling you guys about. Actually, I don't know if I'm gonna put the clip in, but yes, he has an Evo 10. And yeah, we might do a little drive along and a little race here now and then. But yeah, his Evo is definitely faster than mine. It's an Evo 10. My dream car, 391 horsepower, stock. Well, he has a cold air intake too, so I guess not always stock, so yeah. But yeah, I'll see you guys at 3 when we get the cold air intake, and yeah, peace.
All cleaned up. It's a few dinks over here. I bought the car from my grandma, of course. So yeah, I had this car for a long time, so there's gonna be a couple dinks that I'm gonna have to fix up. But yeah, we got her cleaned up, got her looking nice again. So, and parked her in the garage, of course, so it doesn't get dirty outside. But took the thing off for the license plate so it looks more mean and doesn't look girly. It actually looks like a guy's car, you know. Got the tent. Oh, I can't wait to get the wheels. The wheels are gonna be the best part. But yeah, can't wait to get that cold air intake at 3 o'clock today. And we're gonna install it tomorrow at 12. Oh man, you guys will see the next day for that. That's gonna be fun. Keep my car cooler. And it won't overheat, of course, because that's what it's been doing. Yeah, I'm gonna get a bunch of parts to keep the car cool. I want the car to stay cool at all times and do not want it to overheat or even want the notch to go up at all. So yeah, after the cold air intake, we're gonna go get the car serviced, make sure that my engine's running fine, because I feel like there might be something wrong with it because it's making a little stutter noise. So we're gonna go ahead and check that out. All right, they just called me, or I just called them and checked if the K&N cold air intake is there for the 3.5, and it is there. So we're going to go ahead and go pick that up. So yeah, I'll see you guys at O'Reilly's when we go ahead and pick up the cold air intake. See you guys. All right, we're here at O'Reilly's, as you can see right there. So yeah, we're about to go inside, get the package, cold air intake, and yeah, we're gonna put it on tomorrow at 12 o'clock with my friend Xavier. So yeah, I'm very excited, if you can't tell. So yeah, I just can't wait to go see it. So yeah, let's go. All right, guys, here it is, the K&N cold air intake. So yeah, it says a guaranteed decrease in horsepower, so that's cool. So we get a little bit more horsepower in the car, 3.5. I mainly got this for the cold air intake, you know, the cold air flow, to help my car stop overheating, because I drive up and down the hill every day and it tends to overheat like right when I get to the top of the mountain. The meter starts going up and I turn on the heater to 90, blast it and roll my windows down. And it's a pain out here in the high desert. It's 80 to 90 degrees every day. Summertime, so yeah, it was definitely a good investment to put this in the car. Also going to get the car serviced either later on today or next Thursday. So there will be a video on that and getting the car serviced and seeing what's wrong with it, because my service engine light's on and my tire pressure light. But I checked my tire pressure. I got my tires fixed. And they said it was fine, but my light's still on. So it also might be my sensor that's wrong. So I might have to get a new sensor for that, and my light should go off. So we will see. But yeah, we finally got this baby. The cold air intake K&N version. So yeah, it's guaranteed in horsepower. It's gonna make my car a little louder, sound a little bit better, and yeah, make it a little bit faster. I believe it gets 13 horsepower. So yeah, we'll see. But here it is. All right, guys, I finally got off the phone with Xavier, and we are going to go ahead and install the cold air intake. Here it is right here. So yeah, I'm vlogging on my phone too, so yeah. So it's a little bit weird, but yes, we're going to go ahead and head over to his house and install it. I don't have the tools at my house, so I can install it by myself, and I really don't know how like that. So yeah, I watched a couple videos and kind of know the idea, but he installed his on his Evo. I already said that, but yeah, we're gonna go ahead and head to his house and install it. I'm gonna go ahead and give you guys a cold start right now without the cold air, K&N cold air intake, and then we're gonna do one with the cold air intake. Kind of not a cold start, but you know what I mean. All right, here we go. Guys, we are here at my friend Xavier's house. His Evo is right there in front of me, and he has, I forgot what kind of car that is, I will ask him, but that was his drift car. I think he's selling it, but yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and flip the camera so you guys can see it. So I'll see you guys in a second.
It is the sexiness itself, my dream, everything I want right here in a car. There it is. We're getting started. There she is.
All right, so basically what happened with my cold air intake, I switched cameras. My friend let me use his. I finally got the cold air intake, K&N cold air intake for the 3.5. It's about time. I've been waiting about a week and a half. There's a long story to it, but let's just say I ordered this thing three different times and K&N didn't give me all the right parts. So I ordered from AutoZone finally picked it up today and just checked. I have all the right parts. So I'm gonna install it today at 7:30. So that's about an hour. So yeah, I'll see you guys in about an hour. Peace. All right, guys, we finally got the piece we needed.
Hey, put me on your Snapchat so
they
can
get off the cam. Oh my God, it's not my Snapchat. No, dude,
put me on
here. Here we go. Not right now. There you go. Let's pop the hood.
Yep. You are?
Yeah.
Is that camera or is that?
It's my phone, the camera.
Oh, Snapchat, goddammit.
No. And there we go. Should be like, probably like 15, 20 minutes most, since we already know how to do it. But, yeah. Okay. We got an almost fully built intake. We got everything taken out of the car that's stock. Just gotta put that on. So yeah, see you guys in a second. All right, guys, my bad, there's people lighting fireworks over here, but this took a full minute to finally get in the car. I do not recommend
K&N. Say that. Ass. Dude, they gave me a fucking hose clamp the same size as the fucking thing. As the same size as the gasket and the same size where the gasket goes on. When you, with my ETS intake for my Evo, they gave me bigger clamps so I could just fucking put my clamp right
these
here,
are all
put
the
everything
same
on,
size.
And drag it over. But instead, we had to fucking fiddle with this and fucking, it worked, obviously, because it's the same size, but it just made it difficult.
Yes. And this right here, like the instructions are really bad. So we finally figured out where that went. I don't know if it's in the right spot, but
and then I don't like this thing is plastic. I don't trust that. Especially how
I had to get a metal one.
I don't trust that
for sure, but it's in there. I'm finna get the start for you guys.
Tell that life game is not the same.
So let's see how it sounds. Hopefully it sounds a little bit more meaner. I really wanted to, so we'll see.
I'm only complaining because my Evo wasn't like this.
Yeah. It's a 3.5 for you. Problems.
All right, cold start with K&N intake.
Alright guys, this is what it sounds like with the K&N installed.
For watching the video, like, comment, and subscribe. I am getting a transmission service, so that's why that noise was in the video. And my car is overheating, so that's probably why you hear all those noises. So I'm fixing all that pretty soon, and we'll have a more updated video on the 3.5. So thank you guys for watching, and peace out.